dialogues in Sankasa Foundation platform. Sankasa Foundation is a social enterprise that has been established to identify and probe issues at the community level and find final solutions for that through dialogue and discussions with stakeholders and the community, and then taking up those issues at the state level and then further at the national level. So this is a policy, 360 degree policy solution laboratory, so to speak. So this is actually a bottoms-up approach towards policy dialogue and solution. So in the first episode, we had actually explored the issues at the ground level for that the migrant laborers in Kerala are facing. So at that point of time, and even now with the second wave of COVID, this issue is very relevant because of the stress that the migrant laborers particularly faced during the COVID pandemic. So we just explored the housing options that were provided by the state government for the migrant laborers in Kerala. But what we discovered was that although the housing has been provided and the migrant laborers are quite satisfied with it, the condition of the housing was much in need for improvement and upgradation, and it did not follow the service norms of housing provision that should be followed across the country. And secondly, what we discovered was that although the migrant laborers were quite satisfied with with the increase in wages that they were receiving, because back in their hometowns, it is much below the daily wage rate. And this discrepancy in wage rate is again an issue that needs to be taken up at the national level as to why is there a discrepancy in wage rate between states, which actually causes this migration to happen. So why can't we actually have uniform wage rates across the country, so which would actually prevent such distress migration to happen between states and even from rural to urban? So that is one policy issue that we need to take up at the national level. Apart from that, we also need to look at private sector interventions that is possible for providing better housing. So what can the Ministry of Housing in convergence with the Ministry of Labour do to improve the housing stock of the migrant laborers in Kerala? So these are two burning issues that we discovered at the community level in Kerala. And so the first dialogue that we had, the big stakeholder issue dialogue that we had was with the Labour Commissioner of Kerala. And there we discussed the issues that pertain to the migrant labour housing as well as to other labour sector issues in Kerala. And after that, the next step was to take up these issues at the national level with the national government. And so the next dialogue was slated with the Chief Labour Commissioner, Director General of the Labour Bureau of India. And so today we would be discussing with him on how we could resolve these issues in Kerala and how we could take up these issues that we actually discovered in Kerala's labor sector, as well as we'll also look at the other trade plays and reforms that the country is coming up with in the labor sector. Ever since he joined, he's brought in a lot of reforms. So we would like to understand from him what are these trade plays and reforms that he's brought in, and how is it going to impact the common man, and what is the Ministry of Labor going to come up with in future in the next couple of years to benefit all of us. So let's listen in and with Sri D.P.S. Negi, the Chief Labour Commissioner, Director General of Labour Bureau of India. Welcome, sir, to the second series of dialogues on Sankasa platform. Sankasa Foundation is a social enterprise that has been set up to understand issues at the community level and take up the issues with all stakeholders, the community, state, and at the national level. So as a first step, we had interviewed the Labour Commissioner of Kerala because we had discovered some issues in Kerala with regard to migrant labourers. And as a second step to this dialogue series, we are interviewing you because you hold the position of the Chief Labour Commissioner of India and also the Director General of Labour and Employment. So without wasting much time, I just come to the trailblazing reforms that you have brought into the sector ever since you took over, in your quintessential leadership style that you bring to every office that you take up. So we, starting from the rationalization of the labor codes, which is a much pending reform needed for the sector, to the gig and platform workers, social security, survey on migrant laborers, and the COVID-19 measures that you've taken. So we would like to listen from you, sir, first about the rationalization of labor codes and what it entails for the common man.
Thank you very much, Vinita ji, and thank you very much to your Sankhya Foundation for inviting me for this talk with the your good self. As you mentioned in the your opening remarks regarding these labor reforms in the country, as you are aware, these labor reforms were much needed in the country because of not only for the welfare of the worker but for the ease of doing the business also. And we were able to merge and amalgamate these all acts into the four labor codes in the month of September 2020. Out of this 44, 12 laws were already repealed by the government as soon as the government came to power. And 29 acts have been amalgamated in the year 2020 and 2019. One wage code was made in the 2019. So in nutshell, we have for labor reforms, we amalgamated in the year 29 acts which were prevalent in the country, and the four labor codes are made, which now is a law of the land. The four labor codes are code wage code number one, number two is social security code, number three is OSH code, number four is IR code, Industrial Relation Code 2020. Because these codes will have rationalized and harmonized all the acts which were prevalent since last more than 70, 80 years. So it is amalgamated into the four codes in that. So these are the amalgamation part, and the implementation part will start once the rules are framed by the both by the center and the state governments. We in the government of India has already ready with the rules of the code, and we are waiting because it's a federal structure. We need to wait to the state governments to formulate their own rules. So we are waiting for them, and we are doing a handholding with them in the nowadays from the ministry. Our secretary, Government of India, is taking a regular meeting with the state governments in batches with all the state governments to help them to make the rules.
How does this impact the common man? So if one has to set up an industry, does it make life easier, much easier for him? And does it improve the ease of doing business as far as the common industrialist or enterprise is concerned?
Madam, you must say how it will help the... It is a win-win situation to all the stakeholders, that is employer, employee, and to the government also. How basically it's going to help much to the workers, because now that there are a lot of provisions for their social security has been kept under this course. The gig and platform workers are covered for the first time in the country. I think India is maybe the number two country in the world in which the social security is being provided to the gig and platform workers. How is going to help the industries and the employer, because now they don't have to go and refer to the acts. Every time the biggest complaint of the businessmen was that there are so many labor laws are there, and this is a very regressive, and they are taking the country in the back foot all the time because of the labor laws. So now we are reduce these labor laws to the minimum unavoidable. Like there won't be any multi-registration. There will be one registration, one return, and portability of all the things will be there. And all the earlier, this is the Inspector Raj will also go away, because now it will be the inspection in the industry will be also done through the computerized web-enabled inspections will be there. So it will help the industry there in a big way. And for the workers, we have we have got a ESIC and EPFO. As I told you, we are including the gig and platform workers. Gig and platform workers are also given social security. There's a concept of the fixed term employment in these things, so that fixed term employment with the new persons can come from the outside, and they can work for a particular period of time. So the new blood and the new ideas can come to the government. And these FTs, employees, those who work with us, they'll get all the benefits which our regular employees get, the benefits of social security. These fixed-term employees will also get for themselves.
So you've also initiated a survey on domestic workers and gig workers across the country. So what is the intention of that survey, and what would it finally result in? So we would like to know more about that, because I think it's the first time in the country that this is being done.
I just want to tell you that Labor Bureau has started the 5 All India surveys in the country. For these 5 surveys are, I'll narrate you. Number 1 is the All India Quarterly Establishment Based Employment Survey. Number 2 is All India Survey on the Migrant Workers. Number 3 is the All India Survey on the Domestic Workers. Number 4 is the All India Survey on the Employment Generated by the Transport Sector. Number 5th is the All India Survey on the Employment Generated by the Professionals. I would like to say, madam, there was a huge data gap in our country, as you are aware. In our country, there's a huge data gap. When the last pandemic came, we were not having the many figures, much wanted figures were not available. And you see in the many of the migrant workers were going from one place to another place, and for the giving benefits and other things, it was becoming difficult. So we have started these surveys, and these are the one of the kind surveys. So once these surveys are completed, 2 of these surveys has been already started. The field work has been already started. The first 2 surveys, that is All India Quarterly Establishment Based Employment Survey and the All India Survey on the Migrant Workers, and the 3rd survey on the employment generated by the professionals is being started yesterday only. And other 2 surveys will also started shortly by the Labor Bureau under Ministry of Labor and Employment. And once this data come, it will fill the huge data gaps which were there. And government will be knowing what is the position of the quarterly employment and unemployment in the country, what are the social security benefits to them, what are their health conditions, what are their health welfare benefits are given to these workers. It will be quarterly, every quarter will know. Just take the example of one thing I would like to say. Because many of the surveys, they are urban biased, you know, but most of the manufacturing, big plants, big industries are coming up in the semi-urban, peri-urban or in the rural areas, because the piece of land, 300, 400 acres are available in the rural areas. So they are not taking into those into account. So once these surveys are completed, I'm very sure that real data will come to the government every quarter.
Right, sir. Indeed, a historic act and step, sir. But would it also result finally in the Ministry of Labour, the Government of India, taking a stand that even gig workers or the domestic workers should also come under the security benefits of the country?
Madam, all these surveys which are being done by the Labour Bureau, which is an attached office of the Ministry, which is a time-tested organization. Once these all surveys are done, all the data and information will be used to make the evidence-based policy. Right now, policies are made on the on the kickstart manner, which doesn't have the ground realities sometime into the policy formulation. So when this data will come to us, this will be used in all our policies. And to begin with, first will be the we'll be using this all data for providing them the social security to the gig and platform workers, to domestic workers, because the contribution of domestic workers is a huge in the national economy, but it is never accounted anywhere. And the domestic workers survey is a demand of the hour. It has been asked since 10-12 years, but nobody took a view. But the government this time took a stand. We should do a survey of the domestic workers also. And I would like to say, along with this 5 major survey, the Ministry of Labor has been also interested under the labor under the DGLW to make the web-based app for the making national database for the unorganized workers, in which we'll capture the data of the all unorganized workers. You know that around more than 93% of the workers in the country are in the unorganized workers. So to get a social security for them, it is becoming a huge challenge to the government, because they are nowhere registered. Because only the 3-4% are in the formal sector, which is captured by our EPFO and ESIC, but the major chunk is unorganized workers. So these all surveys coupled with the NDUW, our that database will give a huge data to the government, in which the all the social security benefits will be go in a targeted manner to the right persons.
Because if so this would also mean that our informal sector, you know, we say 97 or 95% of our workforce is informal. So after they come into the social security umbrella, so to speak, we could have a large percentage of workforce coming into the formal sector as well. So that's a very historical step that's being taken, isn't it? It's a radical sweeping change in the entire gamut of the labor sector in the country.
Yes, madam. Once these surveys are done and this portal things are completed, this will lead to the bringing them to the formal side also. As the informality becomes the formal, come to the formal sector, the formal to the organized sector, all the benefits will start going to them. But let me repeat, it does not mean, I mean, till they come here, as soon as they are taken into these surveys, as soon as they come to NDW portal, all the benefits of social security will start trickling down to them. And in a series also, madam, if you see our ESIC organization is there, it has got medical facilities or jo inki branches hai, right now it's in 566 districts of the country. We are increasing it to the 740 districts across the country. We are increasing because unorganized workers are everywhere. It's not only in the some particular districts are there. Of course, in some districts, there's the migrant workers, unorganized workers, domestic laborers are more. But now we increase the coverage of the ESIC into Pan India 740 districts.
Let's move on to the COVID-19 that we've all been, you know, victims of this pandemic-stricken environment that the globe is going through. So we understand that the Ministry of Labour has also taken up a lot of measures of outreach towards the victims of the COVID-19 families, and to extend the ESIC and EPFO outreach to them, sir. So could you just tell us something about that as to what the Ministry of Labour is doing towards that?
Madam, first of all, I would like to tell to through your Sankhya Foundation, I would like to tell to all my workers, brothers and sisters, those will listen to this our conversation. Government is really worried about them. The pandemic, it is not only in India, it's a worldwide phenomena. Of course, it hits more in our country because many of the people who are very, very poor, they could not get the facilities. And I wish them, those who are recovered, all the best for their health. And those who are not recovered, I wish their early recovery. In the series of what government can do, government has, as you are announced, government remedy has announced the last year also package. And this year also, Labor Ministry has taken because lead in this announcement through our ESIC and EPFO, both to the workers and to the employers also. ESIC has coverage has been given to more and more people, like the benefit to the payment of 90% of wages to the workers who expired due to COVID, to the wife or to the mother of the insured persons. That has been given to the all the IPs. Under the EPFO also, we are giving the facilities of filing of the late returns, and time has been extended by the EPFO by the government, by the labor ministry.
Since the first step that I took was in Kerala, I had understood the issues of the migrant laborers there, although they are supposed to be much better off in Kerala. So, but we had gone to the housing of the migrant laborers there, and we saw that the government has provided some kind of housing for them, which is way below the national or international norms for a particular habitat that anyone can stay in, sir. But still, the laborers and all are very happy over there because they are getting much more wages than they would get in their Bimaru states from where they come from, so-called Bimaru states, Bihar and Odisha and Madhya Pradesh, etc. So this calls, we thought this calls for a uniform wage across the country. So why can't we standardize these wages across the country so that this distress migration from one state to another reduces, and also between rural to urban. So how could we actually incentivize people to stay back in rural areas? Because one of the missions, as you know, that I was heading was a national rural urban mission, in which we were also trying to retain rural people in rural areas to avoid this distance migration to cities.
Thank you very much, madam, for asking me this question, because this is a very relevant question, because to provide the urban facility in the rural in the rural areas, it's a very for many years government is thinking to provide all those facilities so that the migration stops. But you are right that we need to provide the housing facilities of the national level everywhere. I do agree that we should have minimum wages and the national floor wages for the whole country. Shortly, we are going to hold the meeting of this expert group meeting to fix the minimum wages and the national floor wages to recommend to the government. The meeting will be shortly done. So digital revolution has already taken place. I'm very sure in the other things also, through the more digitization and other things, our digital gap, the gap between the rural and urban areas will come directly or indirectly to the rural areas also, and it will benefit the country as a whole in the coming years.
So now I would like to just give you a platform to speak about your favorite your passioned theme of the Republic Day Tableau, which you were so passionately involved in, the Mehnat Ko Samman Adhikar Ek Samman. So that was indeed a very fascinating tableau that you had made. So could you just tell us as to how you came up with this theme and how you went about this tableau creation and how it was received at the Republic Day Parade?
Mehnat ka samman ho, 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 hak bhi ek samman ho, 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 shram hi swabhiman ho. मजदूर और मजबूत बना, सुरक्षा का विश्वास बढ़ा, माता बहने अलग नहीं है, उनको ये एहसास मिला.
Thank you very much. You have touched the right chord of mine. This tableau, when in September 2020, when this courts were passed in the parliament, I requested to the government and my secretary and to my minister, we should showcase this big bang reform, which is helping all the sections of society, which will be watched by the whole, not only the country, but by the whole world. Because there were many misgivings in the media about the labor reforms and other reforms, because sometimes because of communication gaps, the right thing goes into wrong narratives. I said this is the best platform we can showcase that thing. But as you know, madam, tableau work starts in the government of India in the month of August of every year, and this course was passed by the parliament in the last week of September 2020. We were already late for that, and there is a committee of experts, outside experts, in the Ministry of Defence. Those were all the bureaucrats, are no bureaucrats involved in that committee. The committee of the experts, 10-12 experts were there. So I requested to my secretary and my minister, and they were very kind enough to tell me if we succeed, because it's on merit, because all the ministries compete to showcase their best foot forward in that tableau. All the state put their best foot forward, and they have to compete, and they have to select only the 4, 5, or 6, 7 tableaus to do in the Rajpath in front of the nation and in the world over. So they took a expert committee. I made a presentation. I made a theme along with my team of the creative designers. They were the moving pixels. They were outstanding creative designers to us. And I took their big help. Whatever idea I gave to them, they were able to luckily put them in the shape. And we made up around 9 presentations to the expert committee. But at every round, they delete some ministry or other ministry, that thing. First thing was to come into that, in the reckoning itself was difficult, because it started in the October 1st week. We were already late, but somehow we came and we impressed upon the government, because it's the best time to showcase the labor reforms in the country. And number two, labor ministry, despite the labor abundant country, we have never played our tableau in last 73 years. So that clings to our side. I made a presentation, as I told you, 9 presentations to the committees. One after another round, we qualified all the rounds, and eventually our thing was selected to be put in the Republic Day Parade. And we put our back foot forward, and everybody appreciated, because there was many misgivings and misnarratives about the labor reforms, like the farmers' bills were there, because sometimes the wrong, sometimes the good things which you do, government do also, some people, they bring it in the wrong narratives, and people, those who are not so educated, or those who are not so lucky, those who know about reforms and all, then they start go with the flow. So we were able to showcase our all the labor reforms, all the codes in a one place. And the theme which I gave, I'm very happy myself, I gave name, Mehnat Ko Samman, Adhikar Ek Samman. That means we are showcasing Mehnat Ko Samman. We work, we are bothered about the all the workers in the country. Mehnat Ko Samman means we play as a give a ijjat to them. Not only the labor class, not only workers, even to the employers also, because employer and employee and the government are the equal partners in the nation building. Yeah, all the course we brought it here, you must have seen the from the furnace, something is coming to and building the India. Now, for the first time in the labor course, there is no differentiation between the lady worker or the gents worker. Otherwise, you must have seen people used to differentiate between the, they used to pay less wages to the lady workers for the same type of job, and they should differentiate between the male workers. So now we have made it that for same job, same wages will be paid irrespective of the whether it's a male worker or female worker, male employee or female employee. So that's why the concept it came, and it was appreciated. I'm thankful that it was appreciated by the media. It was appreciated by the world over, by the leaders. We got a lot of feedback about this W. I'm very happy that government gave us the opportunity, and we came to their expectation by putting in the our Labor Ministry W in the form of labor, Big Bang labor reforms in the country, and we were able to succeeded in making the people understand, millions and billions of people across the world, what labor reforms are there, and how it's going to help the all sections of society, not only the workers, the employers also, to the government also, and the feel good factor will be there. That's why we always say, satya mein jayate, shram ve jayate.
So on that note, I would like to end this discussion, sir. Thank you very much for sparing your valuable time. And we would like to take forward some of those policy bottlenecks that we observed in the state of Kerala at the national level as well, sir, in convergence with your ministry and the Ministry of Housing as well. Apart from that, we'll also be in touch with you to know what are your next endeavors on the reforms in the labor sector and how it can be translated to the common man. Thank you very much, sir. Namaste.
Thank you very much, Madam Vinita ji. Your Sankhya Foundation is doing a great job, and the young people like you, those who are so much of expert, who have made such a policy on the not only national level and international level. I'm very happy that that foundation you are running, and people are you're getting a lot of support from the people, and I'm all out to support your this vision and mission to help and to bring the right policies of the government to the aam aadmi ke saath mein samne unko rakhne ke liye. I'm very much thankful to you, and all the best for yourself and to the Sankhya Foundation, and bahut bahut dhanyawad aapka, shukriya.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you.